watching David Graham's Sports Report.
Contrary to what you may have heard, the diner is not closing. Let me repeat that again. The diner on Jacksboro Pike is not closing. As a matter of fact, the diner has been serving this area for 7 years and plans on serving you for many more years to come with daily luncheon specials, fresh homemade desserts, and they still take great big food orders. So, let me repeat this one more time. The diner is not closing. So, having said that, we'll see you soon at the diner on Jacksboro Pike, home of great food, great people, and great service.
When you call for just any ambulance service, you never know what you might get. But when you call Vital Care at 423-562-9370, you'll get an experienced staff, experienced and professional people who know what the word emergency really means. Don't just trust anyone. You do have a choice when it comes to ambulance service in this area.
562-9370. They had their 2013 Lift-A-Thon at Kimball County High School Monday night. A great turnout, and Justin Price was very pleased not only with the support of the community, but the success of his participants, and wants to thank the community for their support, and he wants to thank his players for showing up. They wanted to make this like an NFL combine, and I think they achieved that very thing. Now, we weren't able to be there due to the fact the Cougars baseball team opened up their season against Clinton. It was supposed to be at Clinton, but rain changed all that, so former coach Brad Collette had to come back home to Kimball County High School, and we played up here Monday night. It looked like no one was going to score at all. Both pitchers were on Monday night, Levi Martin for the Dragons and Hunter Scott for the Cougars. Martin went the whole way, and Hunter Scott went six, giving up only 2 runs on 2 hits. We made errors at all the wrong time, and that's what beat us. We gave up 2 runs in the top of the 5th, 1 in the 6th, and that was it. But we didn't score any. It looked like we were going to blow it wide open in the bottom of the 5th inning. As we loaded the bases with nobody out, Jacob Mundy got us started. Bo Ferris got on. Then Tucker Kane got on base. But Joe Williams struck out, and Andrew Evans hit into a 6-4-3 double play. And that took all the steam out of our boys. We never threatened again and lost 3-0. Hunter Scott, though, took the loss, but the runs were unearned, and he had 10 or 11 strikeouts. The next night, we turned around and played at the fairgrounds in Clinton, with the Cougars losing that one as well, 4-3. It started out like the Cougars were going to score every inning as Tate McGee led off. The Cougars, he got plunked on the shoulder and later scored our first run. Bo Ferris scored. Andrew Evans held the Dragons at bay in their half of the first, so we were very confident going into the second inning, but they came out and scored 4 big runs to go ahead 4-2, and we scored another in the third, but that was it for both teams. We had our chances. They played very shallow in the outfield, and a couple of our Cougars took advantage of that. Both teams put the bat on the ball Tuesday night. The thing is, the Dragons plated more runs than did our Cougars. Now, listen up. We play Wednesday afternoon at Brown Archer Field against Union County. First pitch is set for 5 p.m. You can catch this game on the WLAF Sports Network with Greg Brackett and yours truly on the call right here on 1450 WLAF AM, or log on to 1450WLAF.com. Just click on the Listen Live Campbell Baseball right under the Cougars cap on the main page, and it will take you right there. Thursday afternoon, the Baby Cougars will play middle school baseball at home, and home is at Brown Archer Field against Claiborne County. Now, Claiborne County was in the play day, but our Cougars didn't play them. Brian Miracle and my buddy Greg Brackett will have their hands full with a very good Claiborne County team that will be looking to wreck Campbell County Middle School's home opener. All the other games were rained out Monday, so we'll get around and see what's happening in ladies softball and Jellicoe sports as well. We will have the boys' baseball schedule for you, and we'll post it on CougarsRock.net, and we'll let you know on 1450WLAF.com. So keep it tuned right here to the WLAF sports team, and we'll let you know first. We do know the Lady Cougars play against Central Thursday at home, and we'll get down to the Cougar Den and get the story for you, and we'll let you know a lot about Rebecca Mongar and her 2013 Lady Cougars. The middle school Lady Cougars are on the road on the 14th against Norwood at Norwood at 5 p.m. Now, the Lady Blue Devils haven't gotten to play yet either, and they're waiting for the Lady Cougars on the 16th, and that's when we'll get up there and get the story on the Lady Blue Devils. No word yet on the Dixie Youth that will soon be starting up. I think they're practicing now, but playing Nope, they're not playing yet. But when they do, we'll be the first to let you know, so keep it tuned right here to WLAF Sports Network, either on 1450WLAF.com or CougarsRock.net or AM 1450. Folks, it's simple. We at WLAF know you want your local news, weather, and sports quick. That's why we here work so hard to bring it to you as fast as we can. Alrighty, that's all we've got for you today. We want to invite you to go out and see our sponsors, and we want also to invite you to stay tuned. There's a lot more to come right here on WLAF. We hope to see you up at Brown Orchard Field tonight. If we don't see you, please log on and listen in.